Good morning, Mount Olive. It's good to be in the house of the Lord once again. We're in a new month, April. I know we're dealing with a little allergies, but as always, we thank God. I want to read in your hearing John 20, verses 21 through 22 and 29. So Jesus said to them, "Peace to you. As the Father has sent me, I also send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit." Verse 29, Jesus said to him, "Thomas, because you have seen me, you have believed. Blessed are those who have not seen me and yet have believed." Amen, amen. Mount Olive, do you believe? Amen. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for once again waking us up this morning. You didn't have to do it, so we say thank you. We thank you, O Lord God, for life, health, and strength. We thank you for being able to come into the house. We pray, Lord God, that your spirit might fall upon us this day. Meet each one here in the house and those online and around this world where they need, O Lord God. We don't all know what each one needs, but we know you are our master and our father. Cover us and keep us in your hands as only you can. Be with us this day. In your son Jesus' name we do pray. Amen.
Let the church say amen. Come on, let the church say amen again. One more time for the Holy Ghost. Put your hands together. Let's give God some praise this morning. Jesus said, "Go ye therefore, baptize in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit." And that's exactly what we're about to do this morning. We have some baptismal candidates who made their faithful confession. And so we're praying even now that the Lord will come and stir up the waters so that they will go down one way and come up with a brand new position on life. Amen. Father, in the name of Jesus, we pray now that you come and touch these waters. Touch the people who are about to enter into these waters. Change their lives, God, that they may be faithful servants of Jesus Christ. We love you and we thank you. It is in the name of Jesus that we pray. Let every baptized believer say amen. State your full name.
Yasmin Aisha Sherrow.
Sister Sherrow, upon your confession of faith, and as a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, I now baptize. Y'all saw that, didn't you? I now baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. State your full name.
Ariana Melody Clemens.
Sister Clemens, upon your confession of faith, and as a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, I now baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. State your full name.
Keegan Walker.
Brother Walker, upon your confession of faith, and as a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, I now baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Oh, none but the right.
state your full name.
Mizora Carr.
Sister Carr, upon your confession of faith and as a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, I now baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. All right, brother, state your full name.
Ron Blackshear.
Brother Blackshear, upon your confession of faith and as a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, I now baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
I lift my head, I praise you.
y'all put your hands on it. Can I get some of y'all to put your hands on it like this with me? That's it. Come on. Now what I need y'all to do, you know what I need y'all to do? I need y'all to say this. Say, we lift you up.
We lift you up.
That's what I do. That's what I do.
We lift you up.
Oh.
We lift you up.
Say, we lift you up. That's
we
it.
We lift you up.
This morning.
We lift you up.
Lord, we lift you up. Say,
Lord, we lift you up.
Lord, we lift you up.
Lord, we lift you up.
We praise your name.
Lord, we lift you up.
We give you all the honor.
Lord, we lift you up.
We worship your name, Lord.
Lord, we lift you up.
What you gonna do?
Lord, we lift you up.
What you gonna do?
Lord, we lift you up.
What you gonna do?
Lord, we lift you up.
Lord, we lift you up. Say,
Lord,
give him glory. Lift a high praise. Lift up a high praise. Lift up a high praise. He's worthy. Yes, he is. Glory. 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 Come on and lift him up. 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 Glory, glory, glory. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. I come to give the way maker a praise. I come to give the way maker a praise. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you for your blood, God. Thank you for your blood, God. Yes, he died so that I can live. And I want to say thank you. Thank you for your blood, God. Come on, come on, put them together. Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. He's a way maker, a miracle worker. I said he's a miracle worker. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I don't know about you, but I need God to perform a miracle. If you believe him to perform a miracle on today, I dare you to lift your hands and tell God thank you. I dare you to give God thanks right now. Hallelujah. He's a promise keeper. Hallelujah. I say he's a promise keeper. He's a way maker. He's a way maker. Miracle worker. Hallelujah. I say he's a miracle worker. Hallelujah. I believe he's going to do just what he said. I say he's going to do just what he said. I say he's going to do it just what he said. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, we owe him a praise, y'all. Oh, yes. You're the God of miracles, signs and wonders. We believe in your power. We believe in your power. You're the God of signs
and wonders.
You're the God of miracles, signs and wonders. We believe in your power. We believe in your power. supernatural, wonder working. You got the power. You're a miracle. Work your word, Jesus. I put my trust in you. You're a miracle worker, Jesus. I know you can do it. Yes, you are. Yes, you are. Yes, you are. You're a miracle worker.
You're a miracle worker.
I see you doing people. I see you doing people.
You're a miracle worker.
I know you do it again. I know you do it again.
You're a miracle worker.
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 You're a miracle worker. Supernatural, wonder working. 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 Wonder working. Wonder working. Supernatural, supernatural. Wonder working. Supernatural. Wonder working, supernatural. Wonder working, supernatural. Power, 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 power. Send it, God. Send it.
It's prayer time. It's prayer time. The altar is open. It's prayer time. If you know that God that she sang about, if you know that God that we're lifting, come on down and lay your burdens at the altar. One of my favorite movies is Bruce Almighty. Not because I'm a Jim Carrey fan, but because I am a fan of God. And because of everything that I've seen him do. But most of all, because I realize that we serve a God that not only can hear my prayer, but he can hear your prayer at the same time. Not only can he hear our prayers, but he can answer them all at the same time. I'm going to admonish you to lay it down in the master's hand. I'm going to admonish you to put your prayers in the hands of the miracle worker. I'm talking to somebody right now that has talked to their friend. They've talked to their mama. They've talked to their daddy. But right now, their backs are up against the wall, and they're in need of a miracle worker. I'm going to ask, even as you stand in your seats right now, as you stand on your feet, that you bow your heads as we go in a moment of prayer and talk to our Heavenly Father. Most holy and righteous Heavenly Father. Lord, we come right now petitioning you, Lord, for your Holy Spirit to fall fresh today, Lord. Somebody's back has been against the wall, Lord. Somebody has been troubled in their minds, Lord. Somebody is weighed down, Lord. They're trying, Lord, to lay aside every weight that so easily beset them, but it's got them burdened down, Lord. I'm asking now, Lord, that you meet them right now at their needs, Lord. Father God, that you perform a miracle in their lives, Lord. Father God, I pray right now in the name of Jesus that you break that bond on them, Father God, that thing that's holding them captive, Lord. Father God, we pray right now for your healing power, Father God. Father God, we pray right now for the one that's going astray, that restoring power, Lord. I pray right now in the name of Jesus that you stir up the gift in them, Father God, that they come running and running today, that I yield, Father God. Father, that I want to just seek you, Father God. Seek your will, seek your face, seek your desires in my life, Lord. Father God, I'm asking, Lord, Father God, for the one that's struggling with a financial need, Lord. Father God, I pray right now to meet them at that need. For the ones that's short on the food in their homes, Father God, I pray right now that you meet that need, Father God. For Father one that's in need in their marriage, Lord, I pray right now in the name of Jesus that you meet that need, Lord. Father God, continue to cover them, Lord. We plead the blood, Father God. We plead the blood, Lord, over every situation, over every burden, over every mountain, over every hill, Father God, every valley, every dark place in their lives, Lord. Father God, have your way, Father God. Now, Lord, I pray right now, Father God, for the one that's sitting on the couch right now, Lord, that's been troubled in their mind, Father God, having all kind of thoughts running through their mind, Father God, don't know which way to turn, Lord. I pray right now that they put it in the hands of the miracle worker, Lord. Have your way. Father God, I pray right now for the intercessors, Lord, for the ones that need to pray for somebody else, because sometimes, Lord, we're so burdened down that we can't pray for ourselves, Lord. Cover them, Lord. Father God, now, Lord, I pray, Father God, that you prepare our hearts, our souls, and our minds, Father God, to hear a word from you, Lord. We pray right now in the name of Jesus, Father God, that you will touch our pastor, Lord. Father God, I pray right now, Father God, that you would just gird him with your word, Lord. Father God, I pray, Father God, that you give him preaching power, Lord. Father God, I pray right now that you stir up the gift in him, Lord. We pray right now in the name of Jesus for a right now rhema word in somebody's life, Lord. Have your way in this place, 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 Lord. And we'll be so careful, Lord. So careful, Lord, to give you all the honor, all the glory, and all the praise. For it is in your Son, Jesus Christ's name, we pray. Thank God and amen. Thank you.
Come on, let's clap our hands and give God praise. Come on, if you're excited about the miracle that's coming your way, come on, clap your hands. It's all right to open your mouth and give him praise. Hallelujah. Now, I know with all the people that are in here this morning, God has promised some of us some things. Actually, he's promised all of us something. Are y'all excited about what he's promised? You say, well, Brother David, it ain't happened yet. But if he said it, he's got to do it. So come on, we're going to sing about God's promises this morning. If you don't mind, come on, rest on your feet and help us sing this song.
call him in the morning. I can call him in the morning. I can call him in the morning.
Like that, y'all. Jesus promised he'll take care of me. Think about Jesus promise, he'll never ever break his promise. At this time, do we have any first-time visitors in the house today? Do we have any first-time visitors asking that you will stand if this is your first time? Stand, worship me. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Asking that you will remain standing for a second as our ushers will greet you. We thank you for listening to that still small voice that encouraged you to come out and hear a word this morning. On behalf of our pastor, Reverend Dr. Terrance J. Gattis, and our First Lady, Reverend Dr. Elaine Gattis, and the entire Mount Olive Baptist Church, we thank you for coming to serve and worship with us this morning. We thank you for coming to lift our Savior up this morning. And so this time, we ask that you would turn your attention to our announcements.
Good morning, Mount Olive. Please join us for our Keeping It Real Bible Study every Wednesday at 7 p.m. You can join Bible Study on Facebook Live by following Mount Olive Baptist Church, or you could watch us on YouTube Live at www.youtube.com/live and search for Mount Olive Baptist Church of Stockbridge. You can join the Noonday Bible Study every Wednesday at noon via Zoom. If you do not have the Zoom information, please email the church at mobc@bellsouth.net to receive access to Noonday Bible Study. We also have Hype Word every Wednesday at 6:30 p.m. for our youth via Zoom. The ID number is 478-433-2661. The password is Word 2020, all lowercase. Mount Olive, we have a weekly prayer call every Tuesday at 7 p.m. The phone number for the prayer call is 605-313-4820. Access code 619-403. The Prayer Call Ministry has their own email address for prayer requests. If you have any prayer requests, please email them to mobcsprayerline@gmail.com. Also, please be sure to mute your phone when you join the call. Calling all youth, please join us for Youth Church every first, second, and third Sunday. Youth worship services are held in the Heritage Sanctuary at 9 a.m. Please come out and join us for a great Youth Church worship service and bring a friend. Attention all Mount Olive members, please plan to join us for a called church conference today immediately after this morning's worship service. This meeting is being called so that we can discuss the building project. Only those who attend in person will be eligible to vote. All Sunday school classes are canceled today. Please plan to join this very important meeting. Mount Olive, the Hype Drumline will be performing on Friday, April 12th at Radical Nation Citadel of Praise, located at 5898 Georgia 85, Riverdale, Georgia. Please come out and support our drumline. Mount Olive, we're looking for women to sing in our Women's Day Choir. This choir is open to all women that are interested in singing on Women's Day, Sunday, April 14th. We're looking for 50 voices. Rehearsal is on Thursday evening, April 11th at 7 p.m. and Saturday, April 13th at 11 a.m. If you'd like to sing in the Women's Day Choir, please email the church office at mobc@bellsouth.net. Please share your talent with us on Women's Day. Mount Olive, April is Financial Literacy Month. The Women's Ministry is hosting a financial forum on Saturday, April 13th from 4 to 6 p.m. in the Fellowship Hall. The forum will be facilitated by our very own Mount Olive member, Sister Jacqueline Arnold. Calling all women, Proverbs 31:30 says, "Favor is deceitful and beauty is vain, but the woman that feareth the Lord, she shall be praised." Mark your calendars and plan to join us on Sunday, April 14th for our Women's Day celebration. We will have a dynamic guest speaker. Pastor Belinda McCassell of Wesley Chapel United Methodist Church is coming to bless the house and revive our spirits. We're asking all women to wear pastel colors on Women's Day Sunday. As we continue to grow, Mount Olive is looking to implement a small life group ministry to provide opportunities to learn, grow, and connect in small, healthy, intimate groups. Small life groups also provide opportunities for you to discover and learn to use your spiritual gifts. If you're looking for ways to connect and help others at Mount Olive, small group leadership would be a great place to begin. Scan the QR code if you're interested in small group leader training, or join us for an informal meeting on Sunday, April 14th, immediately following service in the front of the sanctuary. Calling all men, there will be a men's ministry meeting next Sunday, April 14th, immediately after worship service in the Heritage Building. All men are invited to attend. Please note that the next New Disciples Orientation class will be held on Saturday, April 20th at 10 a.m. in the Fellowship Hall. If you are a new disciple who have not yet attended orientation, we invite you to attend. OBC at bellsouth.net with your name and phone number. Mount Olive, Sunday, April 21st is Consecration Sunday. We will consecrate all officers and ministry leaders. The Marriage Ministry invites married couples to join us for an afternoon of fun and fellowship on Saturday, April 27th at Clark Community Park from 3 to 7 p.m. for our Walk in Love event. T-shirts are available for pre-ordering today and next Sunday, April 14th, immediately following worship service at the Book Nook. April 14th will be the last day to order. T-shirts will be available for pickup immediately following worship service on Sunday, April 21st at the Book Nook. Clark Community Park is located at 111 Davis Road, Stockbridge, Georgia. Come out and join the Marriage Ministry for an afternoon of fun. Mount Olive, Pastor Gattis and Reverend Elaine will be celebrating their 14th pastoral anniversary at Mount Olive. Let's bless Pastor Gattis and Reverend Elaine with gifts and monetary love offerings. A gift basket will be available in the lobby today through Sunday, April 28th. Please make checks payable to Terrance and or Elaine Gattis, or you can cash at Pastor Gattis directly at $Terrance Gattis or Reverend Elaine at $Dr. Elaine Gattis. We will present all gifts and offerings during the 9 a.m. worship service on April 28th. Mount Olive, the Mount Olive Scholarship is available. All high school seniors that are active Mount Olive members are eligible to apply. Please email the church office at mobc@bellsouth.net if you'd like an application. Please return all completed applications to the church office or scan your completed application to the church's email. The deadline to submit your application is Sunday, April 28th. Mount Olive is tax season. Please email the Finance Ministry at mobcfinanceministry9@gmail.com to request a copy of your 2023 contribution statement. For questions or additional information regarding announcements, please contact the church office.
Come on, this is the day that the Lord has made. Can we stand to our feet and give God some praise? Come on, it's been another week, and the devil has failed again. Somebody ought to put your hands together and give him some praise for that. Hallelujah. We bless the name of the Lord in this place. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. We bless the Lord for allowing us to be in the service one more time. We want to welcome those who are watching live all across these United States. We are, of course, across the great state of Georgia, but we're also in the great states of New York, Maryland, Connecticut, Alabama, Delaware, Mississippi, Missouri, Florida, Michigan, Virginia, and the great state of South Carolina. Come on, let's give all of them a good God bless you. We want to give a big special blessing to those in South Carolina because we need the Gamecocks to win tonight. Amen. I'm just saying. Some people have absolutely no idea what I'm talking about. That's okay. That's okay. First of all, I want to say thank you to all of those who worked with us last week on our Youth Easter program. It was too cute. Amen. Come on, let's give God praise for our babies. Thank you, parents. Thank you, youth ministry, for all of your leadership and the work you do with our children. Also want to give a big thanks to those who are working every week across the street in our outreach center. We had an amazing month, biggest month I think we've had in 1 month so far. 151 families, 6,000 pounds of food delivered. Another 15 families, 500 items of clothing donated. Come on, let's give God praise for that. Keep on doing what y'all doing. Amen, amen. Also, we have a birthday boy who just celebrated his 50th birthday, our very own David Walker. Him 50 now. I asked him, did AARP find him? He said no. They slipping. Because Lord knows, on my birthday, they found me the next day. You want to be a member? I was like, man, they didn't call you. They called me. Congratulations, brother. Come on, let's give him another good God bless you. Happy birthday. Last but not least, we are going to have a quick church conference this afternoon. Immediately after service, we have some information to share with you about our build projects that we're praying that we will be breaking ground shortly. And so we have some things to talk to you about, some things to share with you. So all members, we're going to ask you to stay immediately after service so that we can share the information with you. There's some things that we need to consider. Amen. Amen. Come on, put your hands together and receive the choir as they come again.
Right before the choir comes, I can't allow him to acknowledge me and me not acknowledge one of our altos who's celebrating her birthday on today. Let's celebrate Miss Callie. Now, are there any other April babies in the house? Oh, I see them back there. Yeah. Come on. Give me F. Put me right here, Chris. We're gonna sing to all the April babies. I know I'm getting in trouble for all the other months, but we'll sing to you too, I promise. All right? Y'all ready? One, two, one.
Happy birthday.
Your way, Lord. Have your way, Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, we bless your holy name. Hallelujah. Come on, put your hands together. Let's give God some praise up in here. Spirit of the Lord is in this place. My. There's something about that name. Come on up in here. I said, there's something about that name. Demons tremble at that name. Yokes are broken at that name. Healing happens. There's something. Oh, God, about that name. Jesus. Come on, come on, come on. We'll be here. Come on. Come on, come on, come on, come on. God, I promise you'll feel better if you praise him. Promise it won't feel so bad if you just give him some praise. Because he is still worthy of the glory, the honor, and the praise. Hallelujah. All right. Because we can do this all day. Go on, grab your neighbor by the hand. Let's pray. Ooh. Oh, how precious is your name. It is truly the name that is above every other name. We thank you, God, for the precious gift of Jesus. And we thank you for the gift of the Holy Ghost, who's resting in this place. So we pray now in the name of Jesus, you would come once again and hide this, your preacher. Use me now to preach your word. Somebody might hear. We love you and we thank you. It is in the name of Jesus that we pray. Let every believer say, amen. Come on, let's give God a quick hand clap of praise. There is a word today from the Lord. Now allow me to tell you real quick that today, April the 7th, marks my 20th year of preaching the gospel. I tell you that not to get applause, but I tell you that because I've learned some things in 20 years. And that's what the context of today's text is. I've been praying about that. And this word is for those who are currently serving the Lord. Now, if you ain't serving, don't check out, because I believe God has a calling and anointing on your life too. So you need to hear this word as well. Don't check out. But for those who are serving the Lord, for the disciples in the house, there's a word for you. So I would like to invite your attention to the book of Acts. Acts 14, verses 1 through 3. Y'all need to pray for me. I need readers. Getting older now. Eyes ain't what they used to be. Acts 14, verses 1 through 3. Going to be reading this morning from the New Living Translation. Hear now the word of the Lord. The same thing happened in Iconium. Paul and Barnabas went to the Jewish synagogue and preached with such power that a great number of both Jews and Greeks became believers. Some of the Jews, however, spurned God's message and poisoned the minds of the Gentiles against Paul and Barnabas. But the apostles stayed there a long time, preaching boldly about the grace of the Lord, and the Lord proved their message was true by giving them power to do miraculous signs and wonders. The word of God for the people of God. Somebody ought to say, thanks be to God. You may take your seats in the very presence of the Lord. The grass withers, the flower fadeth thereof, but the word of our God shall in fact stand forever. Please keep your Bibles open. Keep your Bibles open. Keep your applications unlocked. And look again with me for a point of emphasis at that second verse. Here's what it says. Some of the Jews, however, spurned God's message and poisoned the minds of the Gentiles against Paul and Barnabas. Under the unction and direction of the Holy Spirit, I want to put a tag in that portion of scripture and preach briefly from this thought. He never promised it would be easy. He never promised it would be easy. Come on, help me out. Just turn to your neighbor. Say, neighbor, oh neighbor, he never promised it would be easy. Every hand lifted across the sanctuary, say, speak, Lord, I'm listening. Now, if you're ready to hear a word from the Lord, come on, put your hands together. Let's give God some praise. My brothers and sisters, one of my favorite verses of scripture, one of my go-to verses, if you please, is Romans 8, 28. Here's what it says, and we know that all things will work together for the good of those who love God and are called according to his purpose. Can I say that again? And we know that all things, somebody say all things will work together for the good of those who love God and are called according to God's purpose. This scripture always encourages my spirit because it reminds me that no matter how rough things may get as it relates to pastoring and preaching, no matter how rough things might get as it relates to being a disciple of Jesus and serving the Lord, all things, not some things, but all things are going to work out for my good. And I just believe every believer that every disciple disciple ought to commit to memory Romans 8:28, so that when the time comes, you can speak a word over yourself and encourage yourself. That you can speak a word over yourself that will remind you that everything's going to work out in your favor. That you can speak a word to yourself that's going to remind you that everything's going to be all right. That you can speak a word to yourself to remind yourself that at the end of the day, it's all going to work out for your good. Y'all not shouting. Let me see who I'm preaching to. Is there anybody here who can testify he is able to work things out for your good? Wish I had a witness here. Romans 8:28 is a word that can and will encourage your spirit. But there's a truth in Romans 8:28 that we often overlook. And that is, while things will in fact eventually work out for your good, you're gonna have to contend with the bad until the good comes. Okay, let me try it this way. The psalmist said, weeping may endure for a night, but joy is gonna come in the morning. And while we like to shout about the joy that's coming, once again, what we often overlook is that until the morning joy comes, we're going to have to contend with the trouble that caused us to weep during the night. And if you think about it, what this proves, watch, is that Jesus never promised that every day is going to be a good day. Jesus never promised that us weren't going to have to, or not going to have to contend with some trouble. If I could push it a little further, Jesus never promised that walking with him and serving him is going to be easy. I believe this truth is made manifest in a marvelous manner in today's text, because in today's text, we come into contact with two disciples who were dealing with a rough situation. The two disciples that I'm talking about are Paul and Barnabas. And at this point in the history of the early church, Paul and Barnabas are in the city of Iconium. They are in the city being about their father's business. They are in the city serving God's people by preaching and teaching the word of God. They are in the city doing what they've been called and anointed and appointed to do. And according to verse 1 of the text, I'm preaching the word of God. According to verse 1, apparently things were going really well, because the book says that a great number of Jews and Gentiles became believers. In other words, watch, the little church of Iconium was growing. Y'all don't even know when to shout. Let me try that again. I said the church at Iconium was apparently growing. Y'all still ain't with me yet. Let me see if I can paint it from a contemporary brush. In other words, they were putting down chairs during every service because the church were growing. They were running out of parking spaces in the parking lot because the church was growing. They had to go to multiple services because the church was growing. They had people sitting in the overflow because the church was growing. They had to think about adding to their current infrastructure because the church were growing to the glory of God. God was adding to the number. Church was growing. Things were going well in Iconium. But how many of you know that when things are going well, that's when the enemy shows up? Come on up in here. When God is getting the glory, that's when the enemy will show up. When Jesus is seeking to build things up, that's when the enemy will show up, try to tear things down. If you don't believe me, just look at the text, because I just told you that things were going well in Iconium. But in the midst of all that was going well, the Bible says that some Jews showed up to stir up trouble
and poisoned the minds of the people against Paul and Barnabas. Come on, don't miss that part right there. I said some Jews showed up to stir up trouble and poison the minds of the people against Paul and Barnabas. But we really shouldn't be surprised by this, because there's always those people in the crowd who ain't satisfied unless they stirring up trouble. Come on up in here. There's always those people in the church. Always those people on your job. And even always those folk in your own family who love to stir up trouble and plant seeds of drama, dysfunction, and disunity. Come on, don't sit there and get quiet. You might give yourself away. There's always those folk who want to sow seeds of division. As a matter of fact, there's always those people, watch, who the enemy can use to stir up trouble. Because what the enemy knows, watch, is that if he can cause enough trouble, if he can poison enough minds, if he can get us to a place where we're frustrated and mad and even hurt, what the enemy knows is that there's a high probability that we'll throw in the towel and stop serving Jesus. I know I'm right about it. Because there's somebody under the sound of my voice right now who's already walked away from serving the Lord. Somebody under the sound of my voice right now who's been contemplating on more than one occasion stepping away from your service and even stepping away from the church altogether, all because of the foolishness and the drama and the hurt and the mistreatment that you've experienced in the house of the Lord. Come on up in here. It's one thing for people to treat you dirty in the world, but it's a whole different thing when people are treating you dirty in the house of the Lord. It's easy to think about quitting when it gets rough. But allow me to remind you that the only one who's happy when you quit is the devil. Which is why the Holy Ghost sent me here to tell somebody that God is still our refuge and our strength. He's a very present help in time of trouble. And what that means is that he is able to give you the help that you need and the strength that you need to stay on the battlefield and keep on serving the Lord. I need to see who I'm preaching to. Is there anybody here other than the preacher who can say like the songwriter said, I promised him that I will serve him till I die. I'm on the battlefield for the Lord. Here it is. Jesus never promised that it's going to be easy. I ain't telling you what I heard. I'm telling you what I know. He never promised serving him going to be easy. You're going to have to contend with some rough situations if you're going to be a disciple of Jesus. I'm in the book because Jesus said, if you're going to follow me, you're going to have to carry a cross. Which means you're going to have to deal with some burdens. You're going to have to deal with some trouble. You're going to have to deal with some rough times as a disciple of Jesus Christ. But can I give you the shout? Come here, here's a shout. If you pay attention to the text, what you'll discover is that the text is actually tailored to teach all of us. Watch how the Lord will work things out for your good. even when it gets rough in your service. Can I show y'all what I'm talking about? I ain't gonna be long. Watch, watch, watch. When things get rough while you're serving the Lord, watch. The Lord will bless you with what I've come to call holding on power. He'll bless you to hold on, listen, and keep on serving right where you are. Don't miss the end of that. I said he'll bless you to hold on and keep on serving right where you are. I am in the book. Watch the text. Watch, watch, watch. Despite what the Jews were doing, despite the trouble and the seeds of division that the Jews were sowing, the book says that Paul and Barnabas stayed right where they were. They stayed right there in the city, in my sanctified imagination. I can hear them saying, we ain't going nowhere. Us gonna stay right here and keep on preaching the gospel. Us gonna stay right here and keep on serving God's people. Us gonna stay right here and keep on doing what God has called us to do. And come here, if you think about it, staying in that place had to be downright difficult. Because when you're in a place where the people are talking about you dirty, when you're in a place where the people don't value you nor appreciate you, when you're in a place where the people are constantly trying to undermine you, when you're in a place where the people are looking to stab you in your back, when you're in a place where the people ain't even trying to treat you like a child of God, the natural fleshly thing to do in response is cuss those Negroes out and leave that place. But that's not what Paul and Barnabas did. They stayed right there because God had given them holding on power. He had blessed them to able to hold on and keep on serving right where they were. Here it is, serving in certain places will get hard sometimes. I said serving in certain places will get hard sometimes. But if you sit right there, the Lord will bless you with holding on power so that you can hold on and keep on serving. And watch as you serve. What the Lord will show you is that you're able to keep doing what you're doing, not in the absence of your opponents, but in the very presence of the folk who are trying to hate on you and even hurt you. Y'all not feeling me yet? What? Back in the day when I was little, we used to play a game called tag. And in the game called tag, somebody would be it. And when it was starting to move, you needed to run. Because if it found you, it would touch you and you would become it. But watch, there was one place where it could not touch you. It was called home base. And when you got to home base, it could see you, but it couldn't lay a hand on you. What are you trying to tell us, preacher? I'm simply trying to tell you that even in the rough place, God will position you so your haters can see you, but they won't be able to lay a hand on you. Is there anybody here who can testify he's able to build a fence all around you? Won't he do it? Say it. God, I feel like preaching now. Jesus never promised that it would be easy. If you're going to serve him, it's going to get rough. Come on up in here. It wasn't easy for Jesus. Surely, somebody say surely. Surely, it ain't going to always be easy for us. It's going to get rough sometimes when you're serving the Lord. But here's the shout. The Lord will bless you with holding on power. So you can hold on, keep on serving right where you are. But wait, there's more. Because not only will he give you holding on power, here's my favorite one, he also going to give you Holy Ghost power. He's going to give you power so that you can help somebody get the breakthrough and the blessing that they've been praying for. Come on, I know we live in a culture where we're conditioned to believe that it's always all about us. But when it comes to serving Jesus, it ain't always about you. It's also about those around you. Let me say that one more time. It ain't just about you. It's also about those around you. One more time for the people in the back who may have missed it. I said it ain't just about you. It's also about those around you. In other words, watch, the Lord wants to use you to do great things. Y'all missing the shout right there. I said the Lord wants to use you to do great things. Come on, he saved you and made you a believer so that you could do great things for those around you. I know I'm right about it because Jesus said in John right around chapter 14 that those who believe in me will keep doing the work that I'm doing. And here's the shout, and greater things. I need some Bible readers going to help me preach right here. Jesus says, and greater things shall they do. Come here, here it is. The Lord will bless you with Holy Ghost power so that he can use you to do some great things. The Lord's gonna bless you with some power so that you can help somebody get the breakthrough that they've been waiting for. I am still in the book. Watch the text. Watch. Despite what the Jews were doing, despite the trouble and the seeds of division that the Jews were sowing, the Bible says that Paul and Barnabas stayed right there in the city and they kept on serving the Lord. And so look at what the Lord did. The Lord blessed them with power. It's right there in verse 3. The Bible says that the Lord blessed them with power. And watch, it was apparently so much power, oh God, that there was a manifestation of miracles, signs, and wonders in that place. Y'all missed a good place to shout. I said there was so much power in the place that there was a manifestation of miracles, signs, and wonders. Y'all still missing it. I said there was so much power in that place that there was a manifestation of miracles, signs, and wonders. And here's the deep part. Watch. The miracle signs and wonders were not just for Paul and Barnabas. Now the miracle signs and wonders were for the people of God. The miracle signs and wonders were for the people who they were serving. The miracle was for somebody who needed a miracle. The sign was for somebody who needed a sign. And the wonder was for somebody who needed to see the Lord move in a wonderful way in their lives. Here it is. There's some things that you can't do for the Lord and you can't do for the Lord's people in your own strength and power. But when you're willing to be a disciple of Jesus, the Lord will baptize you with Holy Ghost power. And by that power, you'll be able to help somebody get the breakthrough that they've been waiting for. Come in, Peter. Help me close the little sermon. The Bible says that on that day at Pentecost, Peter was anointed and filled with the Holy Ghost. And a few weeks after that, Peter came in contact with a man begging at the gate called Beautiful. The man looked at Peter, asked for silver and gold. But Peter said, silver or gold, I do not have. But in the name of Jesus, in the name that has a whole lot of power, by that power, get up from there and walk. And the Bible says that that man got the breakthrough that he'd been waiting for. So much so that he went into the church jumping, shouting, and giving God some praise. Somebody ought to be able to relate to this, which is why you ought to be praising right now. Because you know and I know, the Lord put some folk around you, and it was those folk he put around you who helped you get the breakthrough that you needed. Is there anybody here who can testify he sent a breakthrough just when you needed it? Is there anybody here who can testify he gave you a reason to give him some praise? If I'm talking to you, go ahead and lift up your hands, open up your mouth, shout hallelujah.
I'm done. Word has been preached. Stand to your feet. I've been at this thing for 20 years. I've learned some things. And I'm going to show you how God showed it to me once again. Not a few days ago, First Lady and I went to get something to eat, went to dinner. We're sitting there talking about the service. They ain't bring us what we wanted. Meal wasn't right. So we're sitting there talking about it. And in that moment, here's exactly what the Holy Ghost said. Pay attention, servant. Because the problem with the current day church is we love to get served. And we critique bad service. All the while not willing to serve anybody. We love to be served. And we demand excellent service. But when it comes to serving the Lord, we are missing in action. We want to get, we ain't trying to give. We want to receive everything, but we're satisfied with doing absolutely nothing. Now, I'm going to give you an out. Here's the out. Here's the out. Because I know that some of you have served. Some of you desire to serve. Not just within the walls of the church. I'm talking about beyond the walls of the church. The problem is, you know and I know, that when you do it, you often run into foolishness. You encounter people who make your serving hard. And you wonder, what is wrong with them? All you're trying to do is serve the Lord. All you're trying to do is do what you feel the Lord is leading you to do. And it gets hard, and you want to quit, and you get frustrated, you get hurt, and I'm here to tell you, ain't nothing worse than church hurt. But I'm going to say it one more time. The only one who's happy when you quit is the devil. He wants you to quit. Because when you quit, that's one less link in the chain. When you throw in the towel, it's one less set of hands that the enemy got to go to battle with. So I'm going to tell you what everybody told me yesterday when they were telling me, congratulating me. Again, if you ain't a Bible reader, you ain't going to get it, but I'm going to say it anyway. Stay on the wall. Stay on the wall. Stay on your post. It's going to get rough, but keep on serving. It's going to get hard, but keep on being a disciple. Because the Lord's going to bless you real good. I'm going to end where I started. All things work together for the good of those. Here's the condition. Who love the Lord and are called according to his purpose. We're going to open the doors of the church right here. There may be somebody in the house who's not yet come to Jesus. Maybe somebody in the house who's not yet confessed the Lord to be your Savior. We're believing that what happened in Iconium is happening right here. Great numbers of people are going to become believers. Here's your opportunity to confess that you're a believer. All you got to do is step out the aisle. Come on this way. Let us consecrate you and welcome you into the family. It's just that simple. All you got to do is walk. And the Lord will meet you in the midst of your move and encourage your spirit and let you know that your walk is not in vain. That your confession of faith is not in vain. He's now going to be with you. And he's going to show you that your confession was not in vain. He's going to show you, as I said in the text, he's going to expose you to some miracles, signs, and wonders. Because that's the kind of God we serve. So while you're thinking, we're going to start singing. And the deacons are going to start praying. The ministers are going to start praying. That somebody will step out of aisle on this day and make the best decision that you can make. That you'll come to Jesus just as you are. Come on, start praying as they're playing and starting to sing. Those online, we're not leaving you out. You too can come to Christ just as you are. Doesn't matter where you are. Doesn't matter if you're in your living room or in your kitchen or even in your bedroom. You too can come to Jesus just as you are. We've made that easy for you here at the mountain. First thing you need to do is repeat these words after me. Are you ready, online audience? I confess with my mouth, I believe in my heart that Jesus Christ is Lord, that God raised him from the dead, and that he's coming back again. If you repeated these words, the Bible says that you are now saved unto the glory of God. But there's one more thing you need to do, online audience. You too need to unite with the body of Christ. We've made that easy for you. All you got to do is go to our website, mobcs.org. It's right there on your screen. Click the button, say, I want to join. Or you can scan that QR code with your phone. It's going to take you to the Mount Olive app. Download the app. Hit the button. Say, I want to join. We want to welcome you into the body of Christ from wherever you may be. Come on, let us pray. Father, we thank you for your word. And we pray now that you hide this word in our hearts. That you encourage our spirits that we might keep on serving you. Bless us to not just be members, but to be disciples. And to use the gifts and the talent and the time and the treasures that you've given us to serve you with all of our hearts, our souls, our minds. Lord, I pray now in the name of Jesus that you breathe on every servant. Those who are serving you now and may have gotten weary, breathe on them. Those who are trying to do their best to serve you and are getting discouraged, breathe on them. Encourage their hearts and their minds. Let them know that you are with them and that you are using them in this season to do great things for the kingdom of our God. We love you and we thank you. It is in the name of Jesus that we pray.
Let every believer say amen. Come on, if you receive that word, put your hands together. Let's give God some praise. Come on, if you receive it, hit that like button, hit that love button. Say, I receive it in the name of Jesus. You may take your seats in the very presence of the Lord. It is giving time. Somebody say amen. And we want to continue to worship God through our giving. You cannot outgive God. The Bible says if you give it to him, he'll give it back to you. Pressed down, shaken together, and running over. The word says if you give him the tenth, every dime, the first dime of every dollar. Here's what he promised in his word. He said, I open up a window of heaven, pour out blessings so big you're not going to be able to receive it. No tricks, no gimmicks. We're just standing flat-footed on the word of our God. Come on, let us pray. Father, we thank you for another opportunity to sow seed into some really good soil. So we pray now in the name of Jesus that you touch our hearts, that we might give cheerfully as you have instructed us to give. We love you and we thank you. It is in the name of Jesus that we pray. Let every givers say amen. You can text to give any amount, 770-626-7477, 770-626-7477, or you can give via the Giblify app. Search for us, Mount Olive Baptist Church, Stockbridge, Georgia. Or you can give via the Mount Olive app. Download the app from your app store, or you can give via our secure website, mobcs.org. Again, mobcs.org. Those in the house, we're going to ask you to give as you exit the sanctuary. Baskets will be made available for you as you leave. Come on, let us pray. Father, we thank you for another opportunity to do what you've ordered us to do in your word, to give and to give generously. We pray now that you come and do what you do best. Take every dime and every dollar. Multiply it so these gifts can be used for the upbuilding of your kingdom right here, right now, at this place and at this time. We love you and we thank you. It is in the name of Jesus that we pray. Let every giver say amen. My brothers and sisters, when we come to the communion table, we must in fact do two things. First, we must look within ourselves, for all of us have fallen short and all of us have sinned. But the good news is that the Bible says that when we confess our sins, our God is faithful and our God is just, and he is able to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. So at this time, won't you please bow your heads and whisper a silent prayer for your own salvation. Amen. After we look within ourselves, we didn't need to look outside of ourselves towards our neighbor. Jesus says that the first of the great commandments is to love the Lord your God with all your heart, your soul, and your mind. This is the first of the great commandments. But the second is equal to the first. Jesus says, love your neighbor as yourself. Therefore, at the time of judgment, God is not going to hold you to account for how your neighbor treated you, but he is going to hold you to account for how you treated your neighbor. So to indicate that we hold no ill will towards our brother nor our sister, won't you please stand and give your neighbor the right handshake of fellowship. Amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Let us pray. Eternal God, we thank you for all that you did for us on a blood-stained cross, that while we were yet sinners, you died for us. But to the glory of our God, you didn't stay in the grave, because early on a Sunday morning, you got up with all power. You got up so that we can get up. You live so that we can live. So we thank you, God, for all that you did for us at Calvary. And we also pray, God, that you would come now, consecrate these elements, that as we partake of them, we will remember what you did for us, simply because you love us. In Jesus' name we pray. Let every believer say amen.
Has everyone been served? Amen. For I have received of the Lord the same that I deliver unto you, that on the night that our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ was betrayed, he took his disciples to an upper room, and there Jesus took bread. And after he blessed it, he then broke it, and he gave it to each of his disciples, including Judas, who he knew was about to betray him. And Jesus said, "This bread is a symbol of my body, broken for each and every one of you at Calvary. As often as you eat this bread, do so in remembrance of me." In the same manner, Jesus then took the cup. And the Lord said, "This cup is a symbol of the New Testament and the blood that was shed for all of us on a blood-stained cross. As often as you eat this bread and then drink from this cup, you do show forth our Savior's suffering afresh until he comes back again. Drink this in remembrance of our Lord and Savior." Amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Thank you, deacons. There are a few people we need to give the right handshake of fellowship to today. When I call your name, I'm going to ask you to come forward, please. And we're going to ask you to stand and face the audience. Ron Blackshear, come on. Missouri Carr. And if I pronounce your name wrong, forgive me. Ariana Clemens, please come forward, face the congregation. Rosalind Norman, Laura Shelton, Yasmin Shiro, Betty Vidal, Armando Vidal, Kamiko Walker, Bernice Williams, and Keegan Walker. If you're here, won't you come forward? Come on, let's give them a good bless you as they come. So listen, we're going to ask you to quickly come give them the handshake of fellowship after the benediction. Remember, we got to go in the conference, so we need you to do it quickly. Don't tarry. Just come on, do it quickly. Come on, stand to your feet, hug your neighbor, tell them I love you. There's absolutely nothing you can do about it. Go on, tell them I love you. Come on, don't be scared. That's your cousin. Tell them. Tell them we love you. Ain't nothing you can do about it. Ho, y'all moving too fast. We ain't gave the benediction. At least put your finger up if you're gonna do it. Come on, let's give the benediction. "Now unto him who is truly able to keep each and every one of us from falling, and then turn around and present us faultless before the throne of joy with exceeding grace, to the all-wise living God who reminded us on this day that he never promised that it would be easy. To that God be all glory, honor, dominion, and power, both now and forevermore." Let all of God's people say, amen, amen, amen. God bless you. Go in peace.